Georgia is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He just drills this one. Oregon's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
So it's second and 10, all on their own 25. He's going to try and scramble. And down he goes, around the 39-yard line. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
He's at midfield. That's a great tackle at the 39-yard line.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
From the 42-yard line, second down. Scrambling around. And he tucked that one in for about 5 yards. Throws incomplete. They got a hand on it.
I thought they did a good job of reading the play and positioning themselves well to break up the pass.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Oregon is looking to go up by 3. The kick is up. It's got the distance. He clanks it off the upright. No good.
Well, that's just unlucky. It looked pretty good from here.
The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled right around the 44-yard line. And a pickup of about 7.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
Second and 3. Ball on their own 44. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The stop at the 44-yard line. That'll bring up second and 3. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's scrambling, gets it out quickly, and he tackles him hard at the 33.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
And he's hit before he could go anywhere. From the 21-yard line, first down. Incomplete. It's knocked down by the defense.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Inside the 10. Tackle at the 6.
He got the ball and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big time speed.
It's first down and they'll be looking for 6 points here. 4-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Looking for six, and he got it. Touchdown.
These guys don't get tense down by the end zone. Sometimes a young quarterback will make a silly mistake, or a receiver will come down with a case of stone hands. But not with this group.
And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 61-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. So our score, 7-0. Georgia is ready to kick it away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Georgia's really got things working right now for him. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line. They get to the quarterback, and now the ball is loose. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily, that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
And they'll probably try to throw here. They line up on third down and 14. Slings it. Tackle made at the 49.
It definitely put them in better field position. I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
Now he tries to buy some time. Tries to get around the corner. Slides down.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Down, three down. Keep 15. Keep 15. Let's
check
go.
Regular.
Check 31.
Big opening. He goes down at the 17-yard line.
First down.
Ready.
Easy.
Lucky.
Slam.
Hot.
The 10. Touchdown, Ducks. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT. So a 6-play, 75-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
We're even at 7 in this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Three down. Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now.
Green, 19.
Got it. Tight end's got the first. And he's taken down at the 33-yard line. first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. They'll work the left side, and he's tackled after positive yardage. We've played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48.
Here we go. Wide 88.
Cut
hot. He's tackled around the 23-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Night, night, sweetheart.
Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers.
Easy, easy. Big dog.
Gets it out to the wide out, and he's got the first. Brought down at the 6-yard line. Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He brings it down. Touchdown.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. He's taken down right around the 40. And he hits him hard at the 36.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
From their own 36-yard line, second down. He fires this one. That's incomplete.
Remember, this is college football. All you need is 1 foot down to be able to make this catch. This time, the wide receiver is just too close to the boundary, not allowing himself to get either his left or right foot down.
Under heavy pressure, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. Fourth and long here after the sack. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He fields the punt at the 20. He showed a good burst there. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Georgia is up by a touchdown. Runs right for a nice game. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's under pressure. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing. scrambling. And he is drilled at the 49-yard line. From the 49-yard line, it's first down.
Regular.
Motion.
And he throws it away.
Tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedster.
From the 38-yard line, first down. Tackle after decent pickup.
That'll bring up second and three.
Georgia up 7 points. Looks to his receiver, first down. And he's tackled at the 14. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's under some heat. And he throws it away. This is the ninth play of this drive. He fights forward to about the 13.
That'll make it third and nine.
And here's another third down. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. Georgia is hoping to make this a two-score game. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one.
The Ducks know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
Well, really good call here by the defensive coordinator. Perfect time to dial up the blitz. The blitz didn't get home, but it did free up a defensive lineman to get to the quarterback to come up with that sack.
He's hit and taken down. He's going to try and scramble. Excellent open field tackle.
That makes it first and 10.
Let's go! 550.
Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Box two.
That'll bring up second and 15.
Scrambling around. He's at the 30, and they make the stop at about the 23-yard line.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
That'll bring up second and 15.
on the run. He's at the 20. Tackle around the 16-yard line. Well, we played a half of football. Georgia's got a 10-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick. You know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know. Do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Is that stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese and Davis, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Nice kick, plenty of distance. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. They run it length. Runs outside for a nice gain. Scrambles. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line, first down. Run there as they work the outside.
Defense is going to let them beat them with the deep passes. So they'll allow those short completions to the tight end.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Fires right side, got his tailback. Tackle made at about the 27-yard line. That makes it first and 10. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line.
Easy, easy, easy. Rally!
Motion.
Rally!
receiver, and he dropped it. Here's the eighth play of the series.
That makes it second and 10.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's level at the 23.
Nothing flashy at all. But now, that first down marker is a lot closer.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 17. He gets sacked on the play. Kick is up. It's got the distance. And he got it. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Georgia's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
He makes his way out to about the 35. They get nice yardage on that run. A nice option play. The tailback gets 6 yards before he's brought down. Fumble. Loose ball. Now the defense has it. The safety to the 20. And he's brought down at the 8-yard line.
Guys in the defensive backfield are ball hawks, and the safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And now he's got room to run. Tackled outside after a nice pickup. He's at the 40, he's at the 30, and he's taken down right around the 26-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He's tackled around the 17-yard line.
That's a deep nine. That brings up second and 9.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Brought down at the 17-yard line.
It looked like he might pick up ahead of steam and get the first, but the defense collapsed on him before he could get there.
What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
he tries to buy some time. He's taken down at the two.
Good vision here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. Didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Georgia with a 6-point lead. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. Knocked out of bounds
at about the 37-yard line.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Setting up play action. Slings it. He might have a chance. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Bulldogs in front by 6. Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through 3. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. From the 30-yard line, second down. Ball is loose, fumble. He picks it up. Look at him go. He's at the 20. Touchdown, and we're all tied up. Touchdown certainly has made it interesting here early in the fourth quarter because now we've got a football game. They'll try to tack on the extra point that will take the lead. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, this is where stars are born. We're early in the fourth quarter. They're behind, but they've got an opportunity to take the lead.
Fires it out. And they push him out at the 29-yard line. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. He's at midfield, and he's tackled at about the 49.
from the 49-yard line. First down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now. Let's go. Ready.
Quick pass.
Very solid game through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he throws it away. From the 34-yard line, first down. And that one's incomplete.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Just throws this one away. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Four down. Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now. Let's go.
The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. It has the distance, and he just drilled it from long range. Georgia is ready to kick it away. Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Nice run to the left there. Carries the ball for a nice game. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He's scrambling. And they make the stop around the 46-yard line. Safety scoops it out. Tackle at the 37. That mistake will cost this offense possession of the ball.
And this young safety was right there to pick up the fumble. Huge break for the defense.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Hey, alert 48.
He gets rid of this one. It's second and 10. Ball on the 37.
Ready! Flag 8!
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. They'll get him for a loss. They lose 4 there.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Right and left, right and left. Four down, four down. Hey, alert
passes out to the tailback on the screen. They'll bring him down around the 40-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week, they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
And he splits the uprights. Kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Oregon's plan today was to keep it in his hands. He has come through for him to this point, and now he's got a chance to maybe ice it.
Yep, they're going to try to find a way to get him the football in space. And it's going to be up to the defense to have at least two defenders near him to prevent that big play. It's going to be exciting to see how this game finishes up.
Just under two to go in the game. He gets to about the 34-yard line. And the halfback picks up 9 yards on the delay.
That brings in second and nine.
Receivers got it on the screen. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and ten.
Man, watch out here, and he's taken down at the 48.
That makes it second and two.
Ready, easy. Eagle.
Gets it out quickly to the 20. He gets hit out of bounds at the 16-yard line. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down.
Watch Mike. Let's go!
168! He tackles him for a loss.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
Good tackle there in space. The Ducks call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. We have less than a minute to go. A little toss across the middle. He's tackled at about the 3 yard line. Them on top. So they'll go for two here and try to go up by a field goal.
You think you're gonna get this? You think you're gonna get this?
He's on the run. They don't get it.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Five wide. There's a fumble. And the ball bounces out of bounds.
I really thought the defense had a chance to get their hands on it, but the ball went out of bounds first. That's got to be disappointing.
It's second down, five to go. Ball on their own 30. Under a minute left.
Doubles.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. And he hauls that one in. That's a great tackle at the 39-yard line.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. Quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Ready!
Wants to go long and does. Missed him.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
It's third and long, and at this stage of this game, they probably have to go to the air. A lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. Caught, open field for the 20. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. Georgia's going to have to use their second time out of the half. This is the type of kick that puts you on the map. If you miss, you're just another kicker. If you make it, you're praised forever. He gets it up. Yes, he made it, and this one is over.
It's really tough to truly appreciate how much pressure there is when you go out there for a kick with everything riding on your leg. Nobody in the stadium right now feels any better than this kid.
This one's in the books. The Bulldogs get the victory, 29-27. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.